Let's make a beat with Move. You can record clips using the record button, the step sequencer, or with the capture button. Let's go to Set Overview by pressing Shift and Step 1. I'll make a new set by pressing a pad, then pressing a track button. Then I'll use Move's browser to pick instrument presets I like. I can adjust the tempo of the set by holding Shift and Step 5, and adjust the tempo using the wheel. I'll start my beat by recording drums using the record button. I'll turn on the metronome by pressing Shift and Step 6 to help keep time. Then I'll use the record button to start and stop recording. I get 4 beats of count in before the recording starts. If I don't like the recording, I can press the delete button to delete that last clip. Let's try again. I can quantize the beat to be more on the grid by holding Shift and Step 16. To turn off the metronome, I'll hold the Shift button and press the Step 6 button. I'm going to make another drum clip. I'll go to Session Mode and select an unlit pad in the same horizontal lane as the drums. This way, I'm recording a second drum clip instead of recording on top of the one I just made. Now I'll toggle back to Note Mode. Another way to record is by using the step sequencer at the bottom of Move. There are 16 step buttons, and you can add drum hits or notes to the sequence by pressing the pad for the drum sample and then selecting the step buttons. Let's add some hi-hats by pressing the hi-hat pad and then clicking every other step button on the sequencer. The step sequencer will automatically play, and I'll hear these 16 steps over again in a loop. I'll also add a kick and a snare by selecting the pad and then adding the steps with the step buttons. If I want to remove a sound from the sequence, I'll press the pad for the drum sound I want to remove. The step sequencer reveals the selected steps, and I can unclick the step buttons to remove the steps. I can also delete all of the steps of a pad at one time by holding the delete button and then pressing the pad. The undo button allows you to go back if you change your mind. I'm happy with the second drum beat. I'd like to record some melodic pads to go with it. I'll continue to hear the active clips in session mode when I change back to note mode. I'll hit the track button to switch to the melodic pads. To record the pads, I'll use the capture button, which remembers the last thing I played and adds it to the clip. I like what I just played, so I'm going to capture that in a clip. Now I can hear my melodic pads and my drums playing together. Back in session mode, I see the new clip of pads I've just captured. I can play these two clips together by pressing them, make combinations, or stop clips from playing by pressing an empty pad in the same horizontal lane as the instrument.